Okay. Yeah. So how many of you have already worked on any ETL tool earlier? So ETL basically, like you can connect to your different data sources, then you can transform that data, and then you can create a final output and load it to some other data source or data destination,
In
right?
destination.
That's a complete end-to-end journey. Yeah, right. That's a complete end-to-end journey of a data through SSIS. Now, when we talk about Alteryx, right? Why Alteryx has, I would say, more advantage and more features than SSIS is like this Alteryx organization is again, California based, and they are completely focusing on the solution or only one product. That is what Alteryx Designer and Server is. Now, what happens in
So,
Alteryx, right? So SSI, yeah, what happens in Alteryx? Like SSIS provides you only one layer out of it, that is ETL. But if you focus on Alteryx, it provides you three different layers. Now, what are those layers? Basically, you can do your ETL task, complete end-to-end ETL. There are more than 400, type of connectors. You can connect to different data sources, get that data, combine, operate it, and then you can create your final extract. That is exactly what SSIS used to do. Now, on top of that data, you can do a lot of analytics, right? So when I say analytics, whether it is your predictive analytics, prescriptive analytics, regression, or regression analysis, all that type of analytics you can do on that data. And then as a third layer, as soon as you are kind of connected to data, you applied analytics, you can do some sort of visualization over it. So Alteryx provides you all three capabilities, right? It is a kind of analytics automation tool. Getting?
Yeah.
Right.
We can
Now,
create reports and
right.
dashboard
Now,
as well here.
yes, we do. Right. So, like what happens in SSIS, you can only work on data. But Alteryx provides all three things end to end, starting from connecting to data, coming back to, the visualization. You can create all step-by-step journey and, kind of visualize your analytics or do the data analytics over it. Right. But
One more though.
let's say whatever you.
Like W prep also
Yeah,
is there,
Vishnu.
right? W prep.
Right.
Now, what is the difference between W prep and Alteryx?
Okay, so Tableau Prep or Tableau Data Builder, right? That allows you to connect to a number of different type of data sources and then do some kind of operations. So when I say some kind of operations, if you look into Tableau Prep or Prep Builder, it has like union, join, clean. There are very few operations which you can apply. You can clean your data, right? There are very few. Hardly if you go by menu, there are I think around seven, six or seven options only. That is what you can do using Tableau Prep. Now, on top of that, definitely you can connect to R and Python, and then you can apply a few more analytics. That is possible in Tableau Prep. But again, that is one part of it, right? Through Tableau Prep, you can only create the data. In order to do the visualization, you need to connect that data to your Tableau desktop. Getting? So we are talking about two different product over here. One is Tableau Data Prep or Prep Builder, and then you have Tableau desktop. But in case of Alteryx, it's only one product, that is Alteryx Designers, that lets you connect to your data, that lets you do the visualization, that lets you do a lot of analytics over it. So all three in one place. Right? Now the question comes, you have created your building on Alteryx, right? You created your workflow, you created your project. How you are going to share that with other people? Because you have not created it for your own personal use, right? That is for our organization, that is for our team, that is for a project. How you are going to share that? Any ideas?
No.
Shikha, Deepak, any ideas? How will you share it? Whatever you create in Alteryx?
No, in Alteryx, I don't have any idea how to share. But yes, I have an idea from Tableau as well.
Okay.
So here we can share with like any kind of, right? We can use, we can convert into any kind of data, right? We can convert into Excel, we can convert into SAS, we can convert into some other
Data sources are also
See,
there, right?
data,
Data sources,
yeah,
and we can export or we can export the data.
okay, I got your point, Vishnu. So you are saying, let's say I created my project in Tableau Designer. Whatever job I created, the whatever workflow I created, I got my final data, and that data can be shared in the, I mean, the format what was required. We can share that format with anybody, right?
Yes, and also like that, we can share workflow also, right? Exactly, Alteryx
My
file.
question is on workflow only. How you are going to share your workflows?
Via email.
See, email definitely you can share. There is no doubt you can share through email. But let me know if, let's say, the file size goes beyond than 10 MB or 20 MB or 25 MB, will sharing anything over email will be a better option? No, right?
No.
That's one drawback. Another thing. Can you please repeat? Okay. So Deepak mentioned by zip file. We can reduce the zip file. I mean, using zip file, we can reduce the size. But I'm coming to my next point, right? Let's say you shared through email, whether zip file or the normal designer package, you shared it with, some team members. Let's say the data sources what you. Yeah, Vishnu, go ahead.
Like we can have any SharePoint or something.
Yeah, that's fine. I mean, there could be a
Tableau
number of
option in
ways, share
Tableau,
drive,
like Tableau
SharePoint.
server. Like here, there is no any option. Like, but whenever we are creating a dashboard in Tableau, we just publish our dashboard in our Tableau server. Either we
Correct.
can publish on Tableau server, or either we can like publish on a Tableau public, so people can
Right.
visit there and see there. Similarly, in Alteryx, there is no any option here to share where we can just deploy our dashboards and whatever we are going to create reports and all. Similarly,
Correct,
in
correct.
SSRS also we have an option to if we are going to publish in a particular server.
Correct.
Right,
I
and
mean,
if we are going to create, so I think Alteryx should be a server, right?
so same, that is what I'm coming to. So in Alteryx Designer, you create all of your jobs, workflows, packages, everything, whatever you want to create. That's a developer tool. Now, in terms of collaboration, when you are supposed to kind of share your, creativity or your project with others, there is another form that is Alteryx Service, right? It follows the same architecture the way you have in Tableau, Tableau Desktop, and then Tableau Server. Over here also you have Alteryx Desktop or Alteryx Designer, and then you have a Alteryx Service. So you can deploy whatever package you create in Alteryx, you can deploy those into Alteryx Servers, right? Few people call it all Alteryx Server, few people call it Alteryx or Analytics Library, right? That is the place where you can publish your packages, but you can publish your workbook, you can publish your macros or whatever dashboard report visualization, whatever you create, you can go ahead and publish it into Alteryx Server or Analytics Library.
I have one question. My question is like in Alteryx tool we have everything, right? We can create the reports, dashboard, it's also related to Tableau ETL as well, right here, Alteryx.
Right.
So why we need Tableau plus Alteryx? Because most of the requirements comes Tableau plus Alteryx. If you are going with one tool on Alteryx only, Then what's the combination with Alteryx?
Okay, so just let me know one thing. How long it's been when you heard about Tableau Prep or Tableau Prep builders?
I think so. Tableau Prep,
have you heard about it
recently, from last 1 or 2 to 3 years back?
Yeah, around 1 year.
Right, very correct. So, and I mean, if you go back before 2 years, right, there was no such tool like Tableau Prep Builder or Tableau Data Prep. It was not there. At that time, there was only one tool, that was Alteryx, that directly used to create extract for Tableau. So you could have done all your ETL tasks in Alteryx, right? Getting data from, you know, n number of data sources, create a direct output file that used to be of a Tableau extract. And in Tableau Desktop, you can directly connect to that file and do the visualization.
I think so, if I am correct, around before Tableau Prep, they were tied up with Alteryx, right? Tableau guys.
That is what I'm talking about.
Yes, yes.
Right? Earlier, there was.
I never worked with Tableau Prep packet, actually. I have only idea about Tableau Server or Tableau Desktop or Tableau Public. So, what's the role of Tableau Prep basically?
Okay, let me just open it. I'll show you that what exactly Tableau Prep is. You can see my screen, right? No.
Yes.
Let me share it. Here we go. Now you can see my screen. So I have just opened, I'm trying to open this Tableau Prep Builder. And as Vishnu mentioned, this tool came in last 2-3 years only. I mean, three, I'm talking about more. It is hardly 2 years.
Yes.
Right. So this tool is only for, you know, data manipulation in Tableau. It doesn't give any kind of visualization. It's only Data Prep Builder. So you can connect to your data. These are the different data sources. What you connect to, I'll select Microsoft Excel. And once you are connected, right, see, it's the same look and feel the way you get in Tableau. And from here, you can drag any sheet. As soon as you drag it,
it's like a Tableau Desktop, actually, right?
Exactly. That's what I'm telling. So over here, let's say if I drag some other sheet, so far I have dragged only one sheet. You can see the metadata, that what columns you have, what data types you have, what type of, you know, sample values are there. And then you can, you know, drag, let's say, some other sheet. As soon as you drag this sheet on top of it, see what happens. It gives you two options, whether you want to do union or you want to join new sheet with the old one. Correct? These two options are there. Now, let's say if I go ahead and drag it separately. Right? I have dragged two sheets now. And what I'm going to do, let me drag one more sheet, let's say orders. Okay. Let me put it on. Sorry, where has it gone? Okay, so what I'll do, you have three sheets over here. What simply I want, okay, I want to drag my people sheet or return sheet on one of the existing sheets. So maybe I can union or join. So let's say if I join, right, it is asking me what type of join you want to apply. See over here the joining criteria, order ID and all. So it says inner join. As soon as we are doing all these operations, you can see like it is already evaluating and looking at the data, telling me the summary about the data, that what are the proper values it is joining, if it is not a match, what information it gives. Over here, so you can see like returns 800 rows. Correct? You can change your joining criteria, whether you want to do outer join or left join, right join. You can change, you can apply more conditions. And then if you want, you can club the results of these. So for I'll just remove it and then I'll drag it again. So you had order and returns. I'll drag people on top of my result. So let's say further join. So what I'm doing, if you look at the flow over here, I had these two sheets, I joined them. Then whatever the result I got, I'm joining that result with my people sheet, correct? And then accordingly, if you click on this plus sign, you have these many more options like clean step, aggregate, pivot, join, union, script, and output. So if you do script, you have the option of R and Python over here. You can connect to R server or Python server, and then you can call some of the scripts related to R and Python. And ultimately, as a final step, if you wish, you can create the output. So I'll just click over here and create the output. Your output is going to look like this. Right? What it does, if you run this tabloprep over here, right, run all the flows, it is going to create a tableau data extract. Over here, you have an option. You want to save it as a file, or you want to directly publish this data source on Tableau server. Right? Select a server, give the information, and it will be saved to the Tableau server. So this is only the data part of Tableau Desktop. They have converted into Tableau Prep Builder. Like you are creating your flow, working on the data, and creating an extract which can directly be used by Tableau Desktop. Getting my point?
Yes.
Right? Now, before this tool came in existence, Tableau Prep Builder, the same task we used to do in Alteryx. Alteryx used to create the data extract file for Tableau. So all data extensive tasks we used to do in Alteryx, and then as soon as extract is ready, you can connect to your Tableau desktop and do the visualization.
We are similar things doing in Tableau desktop, like we are doing join and all everything. So what's the difference here? Like only it's showing the,
Just check with the Tableau desktop. Do you have all these options or very few options?
We have only limited option. You can just join only and on.
Right. We have limited option. Number one, you can do very few tasks over there. And number two, because you are combining your data extensive task and visualization together, Tableau desktop gets slower. So in order to do all data related tasks separately, they created this product, and do all the visualizations, they have Tableau desktop. So by doing so, you are separating the task and improving the performance.
And if I'm correct, by using Tableau Prep and Tableau Desktop, instead of using two, if we use Alteryx, then that's fine and with advanced compared to Tableau Prep and Tableau Desktop. Alteryx can work fine, right?
Yeah, so I mean, still, if you compare these many options and the options what we have in Alteryx, Alteryx have, you know, a lot of advantage.
Yes.
Right.
And so one more thing. Time series, these kind of forecasting features also will not be available in Tableau desktop, right?
In Tableau, you have a forecasting option, but that is very limited. It's the only linear regression what you can do in Tableau.
Yeah.
Correct. Right. But Alteryx has,
so,
you know, a lot of...
If I'm talking about Tableau Prep or Alteryx, so Tableau Prep has a limited option as compared to Alteryx. So Alteryx have a lot of options.
Right.
Okay, that's why Alteryx came in picture. Okay.
That's why, you know, Tableau organization wanted to remove that dependency on Alteryx, and that is why they came up with this particular tool.
Tableau Prep. Alteryx is
Alteryx is a different organization. Tableau is a different organization. And no organization want to remain dependent on others. So that's why Tableau came up with this solution.
Okay.
Right? Now, again, I mean, it is very limited. You can use it for your data related task for Tableau. But in case you want to do end to end like ETL and then perform analytics and then visualization, Alteryx is still a better option.
Okay.
Yeah. So let me close this down. And we'll go to Alteryx.com. Let's look into the different product offered by this particular organization, right? So if you look over here, right, under products, you have Alteryx APA platform, right? What is APA? Okay, let me give one hint. You must have heard about RPA. What is RPA? Yeah.
Robotic Automation.
What is the full form? Robotic?
Automatic tool. Automation tool, yeah.
Okay. Again, RPA is not a tool. RPA is not a tool. Then what RPA is?
It's a process, right?
It's a process. Right? The full form of RPA is Robotic Process Automation. Right, you can automate any regular process using RPA. Now, under RPA, there are many tools. It can be your UiPath, it can be your Blue Prism, it can be, you know, Microsoft Automation, it can be any automation. So there are many tools which are used for automation. Right, and that concept is called Robotic Process Automation, that is RPA. In the same way, you have APA, that is Analytics Process Automation. What is that? Repeat that again.
Analytics Process Automation.
Right. It's Analytics Process Automation, which means, again, we are not particular about any particular tool. We are talking about a concept which can utilize any tool available in the market. It could be your Alteryx, it could be your Tableau, it could be SSIS, it could be any XYZ tool, which can give you end-to-end results starting from your data, utilizing your analytics, and then visualization. Right? Now, before I go to further more into analytics, right, I would like to know the type of analytics. How many type of analytics have you heard about?
Your analytics.
Vishnu, you need to be a little bit louder.
Predictive analytics.
Right, one of them, yes. What else? Shikha, Deepak?
Data inputs? Analytics. Data analytics.
Okay.
You're talking about tool or
I'm talking about the type of analytics which is available in the industry.
Business analytics.
Descriptive.
Right. Okay. So generally, you know, we talk about three type of analytics. On high level, we talk about three type of analytics. First one is descriptive, then it is predictive, and then prescriptive.
Okay.
What is descriptive analytics? And where we do it? Okay, Shikha, any idea about this?
No, sorry.
Okay. Is Deepak back?
Descriptive, if we can say that, is in descriptive, like it's based, right? Okay, now you're getting my voice?
No, I'm getting your voice, but it breaks in between. So.
Okay. So descriptive, basically, if I'm talking about in Tableau terms, like we are using dimension and measure. So dimension is also, we can say that it's data, like in it, the data should be in a textual format.
Okay.
I don't know, I'm correct or not.
Okay, let me tell you. So basically, the order of these analytics, right, it starts from descriptive, then predictive, and then third level is kind of prescriptive. Descriptive, predictive, and then prescriptive. Okay, so as words says, the first word is descriptive, which means to describe something, right? And what we do in Tableau, which is connect to our data, convert that into visualization, so that we can understand what is a trend, what actual information we are getting out of data, right? Using the charts and graphs, we are getting information out of your data. That's the very first thing what we do, right? We are not doing any kind of prediction over there. We are not doing forecasting. In 99% cases in Tableau, we only create visualization and get information out of the data. So getting information out of data is called descriptive analytics. That uses your basic statistics, basic charts, you know, trend, scatter plot, all these things.
Yeah. Right? Can you repeat it? Descriptive?
Yeah, descriptive is the very first step of, you know, analytics that uses your data and gets the information out of it. Right? So getting information out of data is called descriptive analytics. It utilizes your
Any
basic
example?
Statistics. Yeah, for example, trend chart. So let's say if you have, you know, plotted sales trend for last 6 months, you will know whether your sales is going in positive in right direction or you need some improvement there. Right?
Okay.
Looking at the trend, you can say that we are doing good. Or if sales is going down, you will say we are not doing good.
If we compare from last 4 or 5 months by seeing that,
yeah.
We can...
Right. So that is the information you directly get as soon as you plot your trend chart. No other step is required. You will automatically know that whether your business is doing good or not as soon as you plot a trend chart. But if I ask you, let's say you have been getting a 5% growth every month in last 6 months, right? What will be your growth after 10 months or 1 year? If I ask this question, what will you do?
That's called predictive by forecasting.
Right. If you are asking question about future from your data, then that is your predictive analytics. And over there, you do the forecasting.
Okay, got it. I got it, the predictive. But descriptive, like if we create chart and we are just giving the information on the basis of, like, getting my...
Yep. Shrikha, it is
Hello?
Not productive, it is predictive.
Yes,
P-R-U. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm just asking about the descriptive, actually. In case of descriptive, we creating the bar chart, right?
Right.
So, but putting in the data and we are getting the result, that is descriptive.
I'm getting echo. Shika, sorry, you need to repeat your question. So you said that in descriptive, you have created bar chart, then?
If we want to put any of the data and we just get the result, so that is called a descriptive. It's
right,
not
right.
Only on trend basis, it's any of the chart, right?
Trend, I just used one example. It can be any
yeah,
chart, right? Even if you get, let's say you have, you know, three segments, let's say in India, you have 29 states. If you show the sales of all 29 states, let's say there is a product and we are selling that product in all 29 states, what is the number or what is the sales amount what we are generating out of those 29 states? That's a descriptive information, right? We know which are my top performing states, which are my lowest performing states. So that's a descriptive. But if I want to ask a question about future, let's say in Delhi, we are selling $500 or maybe 500 products in a month. What will be the total sales in next 10 months or in next 1 year? If you ask such questions, that leads towards the predictive analytics. Right? You need to see the factors which are causing the sales to increase, or maybe there could be factors which can cause the sales to go down. That is what we call as predictive analytics. Getting?
Yes.
Any doubt, anybody?
No.
No doubts. Okay. Then my question is, what is prescriptive analytics? What is prescriptive? And how, I mean, what is the meaning of prescriptive? Where it came from? Where this word came from?
Any assumptions data is, we can say, the prescriptive. Any futures data.
But that we can get in predictive
like
analytics, right?
Okay.
Regular something.
Regular, you mean?
Perceptions.
It's not perception. Okay. Let me give you a very fair example here. Let's say you are not feeling well. You visit the doctor, right? And the doctor gives some prescription and then you go and buy medicine. We do that thing, right? Basis the prescription, we go to, a medical shop and we buy the medicine. That's a prescription. Now tell me one question, one answer. If you visit 10 doctors, are they going to prescribe the same thing?
No.
Right? Depending on their experience, they might, prescribe you different medicine. Maybe all of those medicines will be catering the same thing, right? But they can give different names. Correct?
Yes.
So looking at the current situation of your health, they are prescribing something. The same thing happens in analytics. Looking at the current trend, if you, let's say, you identified, you did the descriptive analytics and you saw that your business is kind of doing average, you're not kind of doing very good or very poor, you are going well, right? It's average. Now let's say there is a demand from leadership that I need to increase sales 5% every month. Okay. Leadership wants to increase the sales 5% every month. This is the demand. Now, looking at the current trend, you said we are doing only 2%. How can we do 5%? But leadership want to do it 5%. So you will have to change something, right, in the organization in order to change your growth percentage. So what are the things you will prescribe? What are the things you will change in the organization? That comes in under prescriptive analytics. Is it clear?
Yes.
Right? Which means it is prescriptive analytics talks about the root cause analysis. It talks about the different factors which can, lead to a better results or poor results.
What are the protocols that we change? The prescriptive, I think so.
Can you please repeat the question?
What are the protocols we are using to change the scenarios from 2% to 5%? That will be the
process. Protocol kind of in.
Means that what kind of changes? That kind of changes, I think so.
It is nothing but decision making, right?
Yeah.
Exactly, decision making. Okay. So what happens? Our goal is to increase the production or sales from 2% to 5%, right? You will take that as a pure primary hypothesis. And then keeping that hypothesis, you will check what are the, you know, factors impacting your growth. What are the factors which are negatively impacting your growth? So you will focus on all these factors separately. And accordingly, you can predict or create your model that will help you, like if you maybe reduce the competition, increase the quality, right, in the product, then sales will automatically increase. Or maybe you can increase the number of your channel partners. So there could be n number of, you know, factors in order to do the predictive modeling or prescriptive modeling, right? But yes, that's a part of your analytics, and that is generally used into Alteryx APA platform. And we'll be doing the similar kind of thing into Designer 2. So anybody who has seen Designer tool, you will get all these kind of components or tools into Alteryx Designer. Predictive, prescriptive, linear. So these things you will get it, right? Okay. Now, as a product.
Can you give me one other example of prescriptive?
Prescriptive. So let's say, because of this COVID-19 right now, most of the businesses are in kind of facing the bad situation. Fine?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Now, just let's talk about, you know, we are taking the real example, right? So let's talk about the speech what, you know, Narendra Modi did in last couple of weeks. So he mentioned, we'll try to kind of bring a lot of businesses in India. Fine? Now, in order to bring that business or foreign companies in India, will they directly come and start doing the business here? Is it possible? Is it that easy?
No.
Right? There are a lot of, you know, homework we need to do. We need to provide that infrastructure. We need to kind of work on the manpower, like whichever area they are going to relocate. Do we have a proper trained skill over there? There are a number of factors, right?
Yes.
Exactly. So looking at these things only, like the area which is easily commutable, where human resource can easily made available, right? Government will give those areas only to those companies. Like you can come here and set up your business. Why? Because this area is connected, number one. Many people can come here. You can get highly trained resources. Is it easy to commute from your international locations? So number of factors will come in picture. And basis those factors only, they will prescribe or give the location. So it is not only on like Excel sheet or data what you kind of do your descriptive, predictive, or prescriptive. It could be in any scenario. Analytics is all about decision making. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. So let's move further. So in terms of product, see, this is again, I mean, as I said, it is not just one product or one tool. It is a combination of your number of tools, APA. Now under that, Alteryx has one tool called Designer. Another tool is called Server. Server is the place where you publish your workbooks, workflows, packages, whatever you create in Designers. Then you have Connect. Connect is basically related to your community, where you kind of, you know, collaborate with different people, talk about the problems, ideas, and spread the awareness around Alteryx programs or tools. Promote is a part of Server only. So whenever you create a workflow, you promote that from, you know, your local environment to the Server environment. And this data sets is basically Alteryx itself provides, you know, kind of a lot of sample data sets. And then as we go into Designer, we will see a lot of, you know, sample projects or workflows which are already created. So we'll look at it in details. Right. So these are the major product. Now, what solution these products are catering to? So these are generally for solutions like for data analysts, data scientists, analytics leaders, data management, and different solutions for academic and students as well. but our main focus will be into this area, right? Now, whether you have Alteryx installed on your system or not, please go ahead and create a profile on this site first of all, right?
Why
I'm asking to create a profile? Because Alteryx itself provides you a lot of learning, which is kind of free, and you can go ahead and look into the resources. So for you can look into, you know, go under resources, and over here you can see a lot of webinars, ebooks, right? Then you have trainings which you can go and follow. So the more you will know about it, more, you know, you will get confidence.
Yes, Satyendra, one doubt. Here if you see, Alteryx certification is there, right?
Right.
Yeah, by designer certification, I think so, it's free of cost, right?
Yes, that's free of cost. I mean, Alteryx has three or four type of certificates. Out of that, I think it charges only for the senior ones, not for the associate ones. Let me just go ahead and I'll show you. So webinars, adapt. Okay, do you see any link for certificates here?
Yeah, if you go there, Alteryx training.
Yeah, in the second. Resources, yeah, in the second Alteryx row, in okay. the last of last row.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so under academy, basically you have these type of certificates, right? Four. And out of this, this one is free. Designer is also free. Only for designer expert, they are charging $150. Okay. And this is like partner technical certificate. So this is for a kind of maybe for an organization wherein you would like to be a, you know, partner with Alteryx as an organization. So that's what, right? And yes, I was talking about basically this portal only, wherein you get a lot of information, whether it is related to your academy, like learning paths in Alteryx, different videos, weekly challenges, right? Interactive lessons. So go and explore all these websites. Knowledge libraries, ideas. Ideas is generally the section wherein, let's say, there is some feature which is not there in Alteryx, but people are looking for it. So you can see there was one idea which I was also following. It was related to Azure Blob. So Alteryx doesn't provide a native connectivity with Azure Blob. Do you know what is blob storage? Okay, so likewise, it's a cloud storage provided by Azure Cloud, and you don't have any native connector to Azure, you know, storage in Alteryx. So Alteryx team is kind of working on it, and as soon as they will enable it, I think it will be a good achievement for Alteryx. Right, so you can search for, you know, different ideas what they are working on. Then you have use cases, different awards, programs, right? So it is good to kind of go and explore this website, at least create your profile and start following it, so that you will know that what are the things happening around Alteryx. Okay, now I'll go ahead and, because I have already installed Alteryx on my system, I'll go ahead and open it. So Alteryx Designer 2020.1, that is what I have. If you don't have, please install it today so that tomorrow we can start exploring different functions, tools, and options within Alteryx Designer. Yeah, here we go. So as soon as, like, first time you open Alteryx, you will get this particular look and feel over here, right?
Yes.
So
yes.
Out of this, if you see, there are primary three windows, what you can see, or maybe I would say four segments on this screen, what you see. Your this white area, what you see, it says a message like drop your tools here. So this is generally the canvas.
Yeah, over there here, there were two things coming. One is this 2020.1. Another is there with the R programming. There is difference between them.
Okay. So
once I started downloading this Alteryx, there were two things. one with the R programming, one with the simple.
So I would say go with the first one, like the first option what you get, right? Alteryx designed with admin capabilities. Right. If you install that in that you can, you know, whether it is with R or without R, you can do all the capabilities as you go, depending on the requirement. Right. The one which you see with R, it has, you know, R already kind of a component wherein you can do your analytics. That's why, you know, it comes like this. But go with the first option, so you will have capability to add or remove in any time whenever you want.
Okay.
Right. So over here, it says the canvas. This is the place where you can drag and drop your tools. So it says drop your tool here. Tools, when we say tools, basically, you see all these icons over here. These are the individual tools. Like browse, input, output, text input, data cleansing, right? So these are the tools which we will be using as we go further. Now, this particular tab is generally we call as configuration tab or configuration pane. So whatever tool you drag, let's see if I drag browse, you can see the related options here. Let me drag input data and then you will have a different options. So see, depending on the tool, this configuration pane will have a different options. Now the third pane which you get, that is this area, that is your result set. So whenever you connect to your data, you will see the different result sets, whether it is error or if it is successful, or it is a successful data or metadata related to the data, that you can see here. Right now, just one question. This is data which is highlighted right now. What is metadata?
Metadata is nothing but data about data.
Data about, like data.
About variables.
Yeah.
Okay. What information it can have? An example of metadata.
What are the variables available in that data set, particular data set? That variable.
So variable means. Yeah, variable means simple the columns what we have, right?
Yes, sir.
What else?
And observations.
Can you please repeat?
Observations.
Observation, for example?
Like particular record.
No, in metadata you don't get record. If you want to see the record, you need to go to data.
Yeah,
right.
Metadata only will get column names and column labels.
Just look here. See what it talks about. Record. Name. Type. Type is data type. What is the size of that data type? What is the source of that data type or field? And the description about the field.
Yeah.
Right? So it provides you all this information in metadata.
Similarly, we can find these information in data as well, right?
I may not agree with that. Let's say I have data in my Excel sheet. By looking at the data, would you know like what is the data type and what is the size of it?
No, we can't.
Right. But over here, you can get that information. As soon as you connect to data, you can get that information.
Okay, got it. For example, if I'm talking about while we are creating the like employee table, for example. So in employee table, in the creation of time, we mention the data type, employee ID is integer type and employee name is varchar, right? So while we are just selecting the data, that is called data, right? In selecting the data, we are getting the columns only in case of selection. Or while we are creating, we only the about the table name plus column name plus data type as well. So that is called metadata. It's like that.
Yep. So while creation
data
of
about any, data.
Exactly, data about data. So while creation of an object, like if I take the example of SQL Server, right? In SQL Server, while creating any object, we specify whether we want an integer field, numerical field, float, or string, whatever we want. And we give the, if it is, let's say, string, we specify further that. I mean, if it is varchar, nvarchar, and what is the size we want to kind of give. So we give all that information, okay. Right? That's a metadata.
Okay, got it.
But if it is a name field, and within the name, let's say it has a name called Satendra, so Satendra will not be the metadata. Satendra is data. Right? The actual value is going to be the data, but the definition of that field is called metadata.
The name is basically, if I'm talking about name, that is called metadata. If the value is coming, that is called data, right?
Even the characteristics of name, that will be the metadata. Fine. Characteristics means what is the size, what is the character length and all. That will be part of your metadata.
And like columns names are a data and columns volumes are metadata, right?
No, just opposite. Column names are metadata, column values are data.
Okay, got it.
Okay, now we talked about these three panes over here. One is your result pane. This is your canvas.
Miss column header. Column header is metadata and whatever in the column values, it is the data.
Correct. Okay. Now we'll go ahead and just look about these tools over here. So under these tools, right, this segment basically. Right now we are at favorite tab. Favorite tab means there are two ways you can have favorite tab. Or maybe tools on the favorite tab. Number one, the tools which you use a lot, they will automatically come into this particular tab. Or in case you want to add any tool in the favorite tab, go to a particular tab and just click on this star mark. As soon as you do that, you can see the tool onto the favorite tab. Right? So this talks about the tools which you use very frequently. Or you have marked them as favorite, right? Then apart from this, if you go apart from the favorite tab, if you go to other tabs, for example, in and out. So browse is already there. We'll talk about that browse, that what it exactly does. But apart from that, date, time, now, directory, input data, map input, output, and text. So for example, in SSIS, you have source data. I mean, in data flow task, you have source data or source connection, right? Similarly, over here, you will use input data, like where you are getting your data from. After doing the operation, if you need to dump the result somewhere, you will use output data. So in order to get data into workflow, you will use input. In order to store the result somewhere, you will use output. So similarly, I mean, we'll go one by one out of these, you know, tools. We'll see the practical application. But right now, in and out generally have, you know, these tools. Preparation will have things like this: auto field, create sample, data cleaning, filter, formula, generate rows, and then you have some other fields like select, sort, tiles, random sample, right? Okay, what is a random sampling and where do we use it?
Random sampling.
Why generally we do the sampling?
Generally, this random sampling will be used in mainly election purpose, like election polls.
Mm-hmm. So, okay. that's a very good example. So generally what happens, whenever we do, you know, analytics or do statistical analysis, we discuss about two points. Number one, population, and number two, sample. Right? Population is generally the complete data set what you get. So if I talk about the population of India is 135 crore. But in order to get the consensus, let's say people want whether they're supporting lockdown or not, am I going to ask all 135 crore people and get their idea that whether they're supporting lockdown or not? No, right? Nobody can do that.
Yes.
Nobody can do that. Even nobody can think of doing that. So what we generally do, we choose some areas, go and talk to very few people, and then we get the ideas, and accordingly we produce the report of related areas. That is, we call that we did talk to sample, I mean, random people. We did the random sampling, and after that we are kind of producing the result. So at the place of working on the complete population, we are working a small set of that. And that is what we call as random sampling. There could be, right? There could be n number of ways you can get your sample data, but random sampling is the best one so that it is not biased.
Like population of India is like 130 crore, and that is called as
population.
What's the exact you want to say that? Yeah, this is called a this is population 130 crore. So here, what is random sampling?
Okay, 130 crore is
only a few groups,
right? So 135 is the complete data set, right?
Yeah.
But in order to get, you know, some consensus or some idea, I'm not going to talk all 135 crore peoples. I will be talking to some random people in different areas, cities or states. Right? And then whatever ideas or high level ideas I will get from those people, I'll say that this is what India wants, right? It is something like that.
Right.
So okay. That is what we call working on a sample data. Same thing goes with, you know, let's say you got a data set of, you know, 1 TB, 1 TB. Generally, all the systems will not support, you know, handling data for 1 TB. So what you will do, you will take a set of that data, a subset of that data, and do your analytics over this. And accordingly, you will say, okay, I have taken 1/5 of the data and it shows that XYZ component has a good growth. So you will kind of say overall population will also show similar kind of growth. Understanding?
Yeah.
Okay.
Basically, you want to say that we can create one group of like,
generally we call it subset.
That is
not the group. Yeah, we call it subset. Yeah. Okay, fine. So that is what happens in the data preparation. Preparation is basically for the data preparation tab. Then you have join tab. Under join, you have append fields, find, replace, fuzzy match, join, multiple join, make group, and union. So you don't have like left, right, left join, right join. As soon as you drag the join component, it automatically tells that what kind of join you want to apply. So over here, if you see, it is left join. This is for right join, right? And accordingly, you can choose any of these options. Okay, join is simple, your inner join. Okay, I'll move. Another thing is related. Another tab is related to your parse data. So basically, let's say you are getting XML data, JSON data, or what is regex? Any idea about this regex? R-E-G-E-X.
Regex.
Yeah. Anybody? No clue. If I talk about the full form of this, the full form of regex is regular expression. Regular expression. Yeah. Now? Any clue?
Yeah, basically regular expression is like a search pattern.
I will not say search, but yes, pattern, that is correct. Right? So that actually helps you in search. That is one of the advantage. Another thing, let's say, I mean, if you are working on Excel, right? Generally, there is a basic problem. In even interviews, people ask, let's say you have first name and last name, or maybe let's say you have first name, middle name, and last name in one field. If I ask you to kind of convert three columns with first name, another column, middle name, and third column as last name, how would you do that?
You need to combine or convert?
No, you need to convert. How would you kind of handle this task? I'm not looking for the correct answers, but I'm looking for the approach. What approach you will start?
Range will take range, right?
Furthermore,
concatenate function.
Shikha, you need to split that. We are not combining, we are separating. From name, we want to split first name, last name, middle initial.
Yeah, split, right.
Generally, you can like. In SAS, generally we'll do with scan function.
I didn't get.
Generally in SAS, we have a function called SAS, scan. We can separate three letters or three words.
Okay, yes. So see, what basically you need to do is, let's say if it is first name, last name, and middle initial, you need to kind of see, you need to see the kind of pattern, right?
Yes.
Pattern like how, if there is a particular space, or if let's say there is a comma, what delimiter you have used between first name, last name, and middle initial. Looking at that pattern, you can split those fields, right? If it is Excel, I will maybe look for a space or maybe a comma. Whatever is the pattern used in the particular field. So those type of handling comes under regex, regular expression. So you look for the expression of delimiters and accordingly you handle that. And that is a main reason. If you see just next to it, there is another control called text to columns. This works exactly the same as it happens in Excel. Correct?
Yes,
then you have transform. Under transform you have like
I have one query, like if we are talking about pattern, like in SQL we are using the like operator,
right?
So this is also pattern matching. Like if I want to find some first name or last name, we just mention the like operator. Similarly, this operation is working like that or something.
Like is different. Like works like as a contains.
Okay.
right? But regular expression is like you are looking for a specific pattern of, you know, delimiters or maybe special signs, special okay. characters.
Okay.
Right. Now, if you go back to transform, yeah, if you go to transform, over here you have different arrangements of your data. So maybe like you want to transpose, you want to summarize, running total, or cross tab. So these different options you can apply. So pivot is also a kind of transform that you can use over here using transpose or using the summary combination.
Yeah.
Then in database, what is in database? I mean, there is a keyword called database and then there is a keyword called in database. What is in database?
No idea.
Shikha and Deepak?
I think so. We'll do all these functions in database.
To connect which database? To database, right? Which database?
Like any other.
Okay. See, if I just change this keyword from in database to in memory,
yeah.
What would you say then? Any clue related to in memory? Or if I call it in memory database? Okay. You must have heard about, like, let's say if your system has a good configuration, right? What happens? Let's take the example of Tableau only. Let's say you're connected to huge data in Tableau desktop and you are doing the visualization. So in that case, okay. Let's say if you create and save the extract, it will consume your system's memory.
Yeah.
Right? Which means if you have a good RAM in your system, the performance of that exercise will be fast. If you have a poor or maybe less RAM, it will be very slow.
Yeah, it is more slow. Yes.
Right. What happens? It utilizes your system's memory.
Yeah.
In the same way, as soon as you install Alteryx into the system, Alteryx occupies some of the space in your RAM and it creates its own database there. Right? That completely depends on your system's RAM.
It's called repository, right?
Not the repository. Repository is kind of, you know, hierarchical folder structure. But okay. If you explore that, you will get, you know, some database also related to Alteryx. So okay. For tasks which are, you know, kind of, you know, data consuming or memory consuming, those tasks are run into that database. And that completely depends on your system memory if you are on designers. But as soon as okay. You publish this into Alteryx server, in that case, it will start using the server's memory.
Okay.
Right? So the task related to like connecting database, streaming database. What is streaming generally?
Streaming means live, right?
Yeah, live data. Right? So let's say notifications, messages. If that type of data is coming, that is called streaming. So you can apply all these operations within the in database of Alteryx. So we can use these things also. Then if you go to reporting, over here you have the charts, generally what is possible in Alteryx. These charts are not that rich as you have in Tableau. These charts are very small and very basic in nature. So you can, right, you can use the visualization capability of Alteryx, but it is not a visualization tool. It is purely and purely your ETL and analytics tool. Okay.
Yeah.
I'll go further. Documentation helps you to kind of create the documentation around your workflow. Spatial data will be related to your geographical information. So geographical information is not always like it is a name of countries or cities or, you know, states. It could be your metro map also. You understand, right, what I said?
Yeah.
It could be map of your building also. The only thing it needs coordinates through which you can plot your data and see the difference distance between one point to another. So any such information which can have coordinates will come under this portion, spatial data. And you can plot, you know, country cities as well, right? But apart from that, it is more than that. It is not limited to city, country, or geographical locations. Interface, it allows you to add, you know, kind of, you know, drop down, list, date, checkbox, all that thing into your Alteryx workflows, right? So we'll be using this also for some projects. Then data investigation, predictive, prescriptive. These will be part of your analytics. These three things, predictive and prescriptive analytics. So these will be part of your analytics. So over here, data investigation, it is all about your descriptive analytics. You will be kind of looking at the summary of your data, doing the profiling of your data, then kind of you'll apply some logics like Pearson correlation and Spearman correlation. What is correlation, by the way? Any idea?
Yes, correlation, it's if I'm talking about in SQL term, there is a correlated query.
Like it's a relationship between two factors.
Right, something like that.
A little bit more. I mean, I need more inputs.
Yeah, we'll say example like now if we take example like COVID. If you put lockdown more, then the cases will become low. But if you lockdown will be free, then the cases will be high. That is the relation.
Basically, a mutual relationship or connection between two or more things.
Okay.
Like that one depends on
the example.
Another.
Yep. I like that example, correlation, lockdown and cases. Okay. Is it necessary that if I'm increasing one thing, the other thing will also increase?
Yeah, it depends.
Right, it depends, right? So correlation can be of two types generally, negative or positive.
Positive.
Right? Negative relationship or negative correlation will be if you are increasing one factor, one variable, other will decrease. Or if it is positive, you will increase one, the second will automatically increase. Right?
Yeah.
So that's a thing called correlation, and we'll see through some charts also. Now, predictive over here, as of now, there are two things only like deploy and score. You can add more tools also if you have a paid version of Alteryx. As of now, these only two tools what you get, which comes as a part of your free tool. Okay. Same goes with prescriptive. Right now, it shows only one simulation sampling. But you will have, you know, many more tools also if you have a better license. Right, it says add or remove tools, so which means it has capability to add other tools. It's connectors. Connectors like Amazon, it is basically connecting to your AWS, MongoDB. See, publish to Tableau server. You can directly create a data extract and publish to Tableau server from here.
Okay.
Data extract, SharePoint input list, SharePoint output list. Same goes with address, right? These are the address fields. What else we have? See, demographic analysis, behavioral analysis, Calgary, developer, laboratory, SDK examples. So over here, you can use Python or HTML development thing. ODBC connectors. See, there are many more other tools which you can add by clicking on this plus sign. Either take it from the community of Alteryx or create your own tool. So that is possible. Right? Any questions so far? The tools, different screens, product, certificate, capability of Alteryx. We are good so far?
Yeah.
Okay. Let me just go ahead and kind of add a few things over here. So I'll just go to my favorite tab. And as I said, that we can add some data. So in order to add data into your canvas, you need to have input data tool. So you just need to drag it here, drag and drop. And as soon as you drag it, you get, because as of now, I have not did any kind of configuration, I get this red comment over here. So if you drag it, you see this configuration option over here. And it says, let's put on yourself mute. If you are not speaking, just put it on mute, right? If anybody want to speak, please unmute yourself. So we'll just go here. Now, yeah, connect to file or database. So this is the only control through which you can connect to your data sources. Now the question comes, how many data sources we can connect in Alteryx? So in order to see that, just click on this dropdown and this another page will open, right? Let me clear everything as of now. Over here, if you see files, this is a list of file-based data sources. You have zip file, text file, SAS file, ClickView files, Microsoft Excel, different formats, Access, right? Then IBM SPSS, JSON, GIS, flat files, XML files, DB files, right? And Alteryx, some of the files. So these are the different files which you can connect in Alteryx. If you go here, data sources, so these are the different type of data sources, basically databases you can connect to. Starting from your Adobe Analytics, Amazon Aurora, Redshift, S3 Bucket, SQL Server, Oracle, MySQL, right? All these things are there. And on top of it, you have, you know, ODBC, OLEDB, and JDBC connections also. So which means you are not limited to the names what you have. You can create a ODBC connection to any data source and you can connect that here. Same goes with gallery. So gallery, right now I don't have any connection, but do you remember what gallery was? I mentioned in the beginning that what gallery is. What's a gallery? Guys, speak.
Actually, gallery is where we store the information.
Right. So information, it's not just the information. Basically, it could be your workflows. It could be your data connections. It could be your, you know, the complete package. It could be your data sources also. So let's say somebody has already created a data source and it is stored in gallery. You can go ahead and take that connection and get the data from this. So it's like that, right? So for now, I'll just go ahead to the files and connect to one's Excel or XLS format. So I'll just connect to these sample files right now I have. Let's say if I select the sample superstore, let's see what happens next. Right, be careful here. I'll be asking some other questions. So because the sheet what I selected, the workbook which I selected, it has number of sheets. So over here you can see order, people and return. Three sheets were there. So you can choose any particular sheet and get the data from there. With that, it gives me option to select a range, sales, rows or columns. Sorry, cells, not sales. Cells, rows and columns. So you can specify, because it is Excel file, you can specify the range also, like you want from A1 to B100. So that kind of range also you can give. Okay, so I will not choose it right now. I have selected the sheet. I can take that complete sheet. Before I go ahead and click on OK, I would like to know from you, what is named range? What is named range?
Range, named range is basically like a Excel. We generally fetching the data, like I have a column A and column B, and I want to move in another sheet that data. So that range is called a named range, I think.
No, so the same thing I can do using this, right? I will specify the range, column A and B, and I'll get that. Why named? Are we giving some name to it?
It is about the column header.
If we have saved any range files and we have given any name, that kind of thing is called name range.
What is range
say
file?
Example, like
mm-hmm. Any clue?
We have taken like from A1 to B20. We have given a name for that range. That is called name range, right?
I think you are coming to that point. Let me just show you that what exactly named range is. Okay. Then we'll come here. Let's say this is my Excel sheet. Let me open some of the data also. For example, okay, let's see. Okay, this is my data over here. What happens in Excel? So let's say if I select this data, this particular range, and I give it a name, I will say my range. Okay. This range, I have given it as a my name range, name box. Right, this is my complete table, but if I'll go ahead and select that particular range, or maybe I can go here and select that thing, my data will be kind of saved into this particular range. What I mean is, we have selected a range and given a name called my range. Just come here to any other sheet and select that. So it will again select that particular data. You have a specified name to a particular range of your data. So if you have that kind of, you know, arrangement done in an Excel sheet, you can go ahead and give that name and select your data.
Okay.
Yeah. That's called named range. Not only here, this.
Mm-hmm. But here we this is the Excel part, right? We are giving right. the name range. Right. But in Alteryx, where we need to mention name?
Okay. See, in Alteryx, you can get the named range in a drop-down only and only if the sheet which you are connecting to has the named range. If it doesn't have, you will not get anything in the drop-down. It is not the Alteryx property, it is Excel property.
Okay.
Because you are connecting to Excel input file.
So we can change the name as well there.
In Excel, you can change, not here.
So in Excel, if we change, then automatically come here, right?
Correct.
Okay.
Okay. So I'll just go back, select my sheet orders. I don't need any range. I'll click on OK. See what happens. As soon as I'm connected, you can see your data over here, sample preview. Now, another point is this preview is like you can see like first 100 records, but maximum it shows only 1 MB data. If you have, you know, more than 1 MB data, it will not show the complete data. It will truncate that. So it's a limited preview. If you have less data and less than 1 MB, then you will get the complete. Otherwise, you won't get the complete data. Other than this, you can see the different properties related to your file. So like record limit, file format, it is Excel, table or query, that is orders you have selected to. Search for subdirectories, we have not done that. Output file name as a field, we have not taken anything. First row contains data. So yes, if you look at it here, first row has the headers. Okay, first row has header. In case you select it has data, then if you refresh, you will get as F1, F2, F3, and your data will, the headers which you were getting earlier, they will move down somewhere because that has converted into data. See, row number one, data, row ID. But the actual case, this is the header, not the data. So I'll uncheck this, refresh. So this will come as a header. Now row number one is this. Fine?
Yeah. Okay.
Any doubt?
When we fetch the name range, so then automatically this window will open, right? In the left side.
Correct. I mean, whether it is a name range, whether it is an Excel file, whatever you connect to, this window will come.
Okay.
Right. Now over here, because we have connected to this particular tool, input, you can see the data. If you click over here, you can. Okay, I need to run basically, then you will see it. Let me select. Yeah, data is here. And then on top of it, you can see different other help menus. Like if you go to help, you will see the detail related to this particular control. You can annotate, you can provide, you know, the description about this. What I'll do as of now for today, let me just go ahead and add one more control or tool. We call it browse. Browse is basically gives you the capability to see your data. So if I just run it, right, you can see through browse, this is your data. The data which you connected to, all the rows, number of rows, the total size of data, and in case you wish to see the metadata, you can see that from here. Like names, data type, size, source, and for description, it is blank at this moment. So it is the metadata related to your data, what you have just connected to. Any questions so far?
No.
Right? It's a simple drag and drop, what we do here. But yes, depending on the tool, what you drag, the configuration window will change, and accordingly, our options will change. Right? Now, the good thing about these connectors is...
Can you repeat this?
Please go ahead.
Can you click on the data? I was just looking. Okay. Okay, got it.
Right. Now, over here, you see the total number of records. If you click on this, it is going to open your source in case of file-based systems. What is the meaning of file-based systems? File-based system?
It's a collection of programs.
Okay, let me go back again to the sample. And what we saw when we connected on data source, you have files, you have data sources, and then gallery. Mm-hmm. Our major focus is on these two at this moment, files and data source, right? So yes, file system data. And under file, you have all those options which will be either located in a shared drive or on your local system. It will be a physical file which you can see on your system.
Okay.
Correct? So any data source which is of this type will be known as file-based system. And anything wherever you don't see that physical, you know, kind of data, you need to query or you need to fetch using query, that you will known that you will call as server-based system or maybe databases. So that's why file-based architecture and server or server-based or client-based architecture have a different way of connectivity. Right? Why I asked this question? Because if you go here and you see that count, if you click on it, if it is file-based system, it will open that source. See? Right, it has opened that file. Same goes with this. If you run it once again, okay, if you get this information, you click on it, it will open that Excel file for you. See,
like in Tableau, we have a multiple file options, right? TWB, TWBX file format, these are called file formats.
Right.
But in Alteryx, in which format the data will save?
I'll just click over here.
Excel is it showing.
No.
Okay. Look at this format. YXDB.
Right. It's an Alteryx DB file, which database. Alteryx has created for internal purpose. Yeah. So the database, in database, which I was talking about, it takes the backup of all such data sources into that database. Okay. Then yes. So over here, if you see the anchors, like between these two connectors, this is your input data and this is your kind of, okay. For each anchor, you have two options. Over here, it is kind of going out and it is kind of input for this particular browse control. You can add this browse control anywhere. Anywhere means whenever you want to see the data, so you can add it. It is very useful, but it doesn't put your data in any other location. If you want to kind of save your data at some location, you need to take output. Right? I'll delete this browse and we'll join this output. And then what this output is going to do, it will ask you the location where you want to save that file. Right? So it's output only, right?
Yes.
Yeah, text output. Let's let's save our data in form of a Excel file, or maybe let's convert that into CSV. And over here, let's say I'll go to desktop. We'll take one folder. Let me create one more folder here. We'll say Alteryx. And I'll just give a name. Let's say test file. CSV format. I'll say OK. So it has taken the further configuration accordingly. Now, I'll just come here and we'll run this.
The data will save in a CSV format.
Right, so it has mentioned that it has kind of converted, it has done some of data conversion also. So that warning you can see here, but ultimately it has saved data into this location. Says test file.csv. So if you want to open that, you can go there. It will open your data into CSV format. See, text.csv. Okay. The good thing about Alteryx is, see this conversion. Looking at the data type, if it is your string field, looking at your data type, it will automatically convert the data type if it is, you know, required.
So where there, did it save this file basically? Just directly right click on the, just mention the .csv, right?
No. I created that folder, right? I went there onto my desktop, created one Alteryx folder. Okay, so it has saved it there.
Fetch the data. Okay.
Yeah. So this is the file what it has created just now. Okay. Any doubt? Any questions?